What's going on, guys? It's Bacardi Wizard for me. The delivery war is finally over. Pretty nice to come back to warring again. And yeah, came in third place, but I bought like 4 Zac token packages to reset my cap. So if it's about 500 per cap, I should be around 5,888 kills instead. I came in third place. So yay! Well, let's get the rewards. Let's try that again. I really should play more conservatively. Okay, finally made it to the boss. Now let's just get this done. Surprisingly easy. I had a tougher time with the mobs. The mobs hit harder than the actual boss. So the boss is just earth, you know, nothing too special, except they just can't be controlled, that's all. And so after a long time of fighting, this is what we got. We can buy. Ooh, that's quite pricey. Okay, we have a shield and we have armor, so let me just buy this stuff and test it out, and let me give you guys my 2 cents. So we got the armor, we got the shield. The main elemental defense is to water, and then the secondary is to ice and darkness. We have a status resistance based on our dexterity. We have an initiative bonus, we're gonna go first more likely, and this is an offensive armor. So when the monster is panicked, we deal 10% less damage to heal 25% of our melee damage, which is quite interesting. So we have 3 armor skills with this armor, and the first one is an attacking skill that uses 113 SP that locks us to range water damage. Very interesting, but the damage is quite unimpressive. Second armor skill right here, Mind and Matter, is why people is calling this a hybrid armor, because using your strength, you are able to empower your skills up to 40.9% for 196 SP per turn. And the last one, Rim and Malice, you can use 20 SP per turn to have a bonus of 6.8 status potence. So if you play around with statuses, this might come in very, very useful. Now this armor right here, it only has one attack animation, which is you just go forth and then you poke the monster with your weapon twice. Honestly, I like that it's a fully offensive armor. The statuses makes it very, very useful, and the armor skills is quite interesting, but because BBFM is a pure warrior, I can't really make use of all the skills, and I'm not very good with statuses, so... But the attacking SP skill right here is locks you to range, which is quite disappointing, but the damage is quite alright, I guess. Overall, I just feel that this is a very quick, very nice set and might be useful in the future.